King George VI of Great Britain greets the more than 6,000 athletes from 59 nations. It is the first Olympiad to be held since the Berlin Games of 1936. The 1940 and 1944 Games were canceled because of World War II. The 12-year moratorium between Berlin and London saw many great careers end without any participation in the Olympic Games. Men and women athletes at their peak during the war years had long since retired. There are two notable exceptions in London. One is Fanny Blankers-Koen of Holland. At age 30 and the mother of two small children, she would go on to win 4 gold medals. The other is Barney Ewell of the United States. In 1940, at age 22, Ewell would have been one of the Olympic favorites in the 100 and 200 meter dashes. In 1944, at age 26, Barney Ewell was still one of the world's great sprinters. But again, he could not compete because of the war. Now here in London, 7 months short of his 31st birthday, Barney Ewell is one of the 6 finalists in the 100 meter dash.
Well, I wished I would have been able to compete in the 1940 games, which was my peak year. But wars, we're going to have wars, I guess, as long as men here on Earth. So taking everything in consideration, I'm extremely fortunate that I was lucky enough to be able to compete on the 48 team.
It is July 31st, 1948, the final of the 100-meter dash. Barney Ewell, wearing number 70, is one of the 3 Americans in the final. The others are Mel Patton and Harrison Dillard. Both Patton and Dillard have won all their heats. There are 4 favorites in the race, all with an equal chance at the gold medal. Patton, lane 1, Ewell, lane 2, Lloyd LaBeach, Panama, lane 3, and Harrison Dillard, lane 6, on the far outside. At 50 meters, Harrison Dillard on the extreme left is in front. Ewell in lane 2 is inches ahead of the other favorites, Patton and LaBeach. At the finish, it is Dillard on the left first, Ewell second, LaBeach third. Ewell is certain he has won. He knows he defeated Patton and LaBeach, but he is unable to see Dillard's finish on the far outside lane. Patton also believes Ewell has won. He congratulates his teammate. But then the announcement is made that Dillard has beaten Ewell by 1 foot.
I thought I had won it because I had beaten LaBeach and Patton, my 2 greatest competitors. But Dillard, he was, as I often have said to him before, he was halfway to Cleveland time I got to the line.
The final placings: Dillard first, Ewell second, LaBeach third. After the 100-meter final, newspaper accounts referred to Barney Ewell as Grandpa and the Old Man. One reporter asked how he felt about making a comeback. His reply, how can you make a comeback when you've never been away?
Being called Old Man or Grandpa or whatever it was didn't upset me in any way. Matter of fact, I really enjoyed being called Old Man because the boys, it sort of give you a compliment. A compliment, it was really a compliment. And if I happen to run a fairly decent race, then they just come around and say, well, still sparking the old man left. So that really turned me on.
It is 3 days later, the final of the 200-meter dash. The favorites in the race are McKinley, Jamaica, LaBeach, Panama, and Patton and Ewell from the United States. Ewell and Patton lead the field in the early stages. In the middle of the turn, LaBeach and McKinley are just a few feet behind Ewell and Patton. Approaching the finish, it is still Patton and Ewell in the lead. Patton first, Ewell second. Barney Ewell has lost his 2nd straight race by just a few inches. It is now Saturday, August 7th. The 400-meter relay. The United States team is the favorite. On the right, Ewell leads off. Lorenzo Wright in the middle awaits Barney Ewell's pass for the second leg. Wright passes to Dillard. The 100-meter gold medal winner puts the United States in the lead. Mel Patton, the 200-meter gold medal winner, takes the final pass from Dillard. United States first, Great Britain second, Italy third. Immediately after the race, Ewell notices discussions taking place amongst the officials.
We wonder why it took so long for them to announce the winner. So they finally made an announcement that the United States team was disqualified. So our hearts sunk. And we wondered just what went wrong. So they come out and said the United States passed out of the zone, and it was done on the first leg, which was my leg. I was just too stunned because I knew that I hadn't ran out of the line. If you compete and lose, well, you just lost. But to compete and find yourself a winner and then find yourself a loser, it sort of does something to you.
Great Britain is moved from second to first place. The United States team protests. For the first time in history, the International Olympic Committee agrees to review the official film. The film is slowed down as Ewell approaches Lorenzo Wright for the first pass-off. Lorenzo Wright now has the baton. The officials view and review the film. Finally, they agree the pass-off was legal. Lorenzo Wright was still several feet within the legal passing zone. An Olympic gold medal finally belongs to Barney Ewell.
I just wish all those races I have lost, I wish I could have won. As I said before, I don't mind losing, but I don't like it.